Welcome back, crime fighters, for another edition of Calhoun County's Most Wanted, the program where you get to help make Calhoun County a better and safer place for all of us by helping us lock up some bad guys, and we will get to that list coming up here in just a few moments. First, let's take a look at the good work that you have done this past week. We had several more arrests, five more to add to the total. Now 3,577 people arrested thanks to information that you shared with us here on Calhoun County's Most Wanted. We'll have this week's list of bad guys coming up in just a few minutes. I want to take a moment to remind you about some other options that you have. If you ever miss this show, we do appreciate you tuning in to watch it. But if you miss the show and you still want to take a look at who is on the list this week and which property crimes have been committed in the area that we're looking for information on, you can always go to the Facebook page for the Calhoun County Sheriff's Office. And we've got videos posted there, one for the Most Wanted lineup and another one for the Crime Stoppers property crimes section there, so you can look at those videos and see the same information that we have here on the show. You can also watch this show on the TV24 website on demand. Go to tv24.tv, click on the on demand button there, and scroll down to Calhoun County's Most Wanted. You can watch the latest episode, or you can scroll down and watch any episode that we've aired in quite a while. I can't remember exactly how many shows are still up there, but it's a nice long list, and you can do some binge watching if you like. But of course, the most recent one is going to be the one that has the information that we need your help with right now. We're going to take a quick break, and when we come back, we'll take a look at the first part of that lineup on Calhoun County's Most Wanted.
What are you doing?
I'm trying to wash my camo so I'm ready for hunting season.
Get that stuff out of my washer. You should take it to a laundromat.
There isn't any good laundries around here.
Sure there is. Wash in Aniston Corn Laundry on Quintard across from Walgreens and beside the Social Security office.
They have a washer that can handle a real man's jacket?
They have the biggest washers and dryers around, and you can get all your stuff finished within an hour.
Awesome. I'm headed to Wash in Aniston Corn Laundry at 829 Quintard, and then I can take the rest of the day to get my other gear ready.
Or maybe you can finish the yard work.
Yeah, right after I sight my bow.
Your word is rigmarole.
Can you define it?
A long, complicated, and annoying process.
Can you use it in a sentence?
The last time I tried to buy a car, I just got a big load of rigmarole.
Well, you should have gone to Jacksonville Auto Sales.
Jacksonville Auto Sales, across from Walmart in Jacksonville, or find us on the web at jascars.com. Remember, Jacksonville Auto Sales, home of the no rigmarole deal.
Amazing grace.
How sweet the sound that saved.
A crackhead.
Drug addict.
Alcoholic.
Meth freak.
A wretch.
Like me.
I once was.
Homeless.
Broken. Sad.
Just lost.
But now I am.
Sober.
Happy.
I'm found. Was blind, but now I see.
Every day, shattered lives are restored thanks to the goods you donate to the Salvation Army.
AOD Federal Credit Union. You already know their friendly staff and great loan products. So here's reason number 8 to choose AOD FCU, a new all-platinum Visa credit card. Call 1-800-637-0299 or visit AODFCU.com to start earning 1% cash back on purchases. Your good credit earns you a better rate. A new platinum Visa card. Another reason you belong at AOD Federal Credit Union.
The Ford brand has always brought you impressive style and legendary quality. And Sonny King Ford brings you the lowest price and the largest inventory, new or pre-owned. The new 2015 F-150 gets the best gas mileage of any truck without giving up its powerful towing capacity. The iconic new 2015 Mustang with its classic pony car looks and hunkered down stance preserves a legacy that defines American motoring. For over 93 years, Sonny King Ford for the best cars and best price.
Hi, I'm Katina Houston with Family Links, and this is the Family Tip of the Week. It's easy for parents to skip over some accomplishments and jump right to the next thing, the undone dishes, the afternoon homework battle. But learning to identify and celebrate your family's success, even if it's small, can really help to create positive momentum and lead to lasting change. Maybe this is the first morning you made it out of the house without an argument in months, but you did it, and it's worth a little celebrating. Follow these tips to help your family change. Number one, be aware of success no matter the size. Change comes in small moments. It's easy to overlook small accomplishments. Recognizing success when it happens is an important first step. Number two, acknowledge the success with your family. This is your moment to be a cheerleader. Parenting is such hard work. It may feel difficult to celebrate something small when larger things still need work, but this is a chance to bring positive energy into your family. Number three, focus on the success and celebrate it. We're not suggesting you go overboard, but stay with your success for a little while. Talk about it, why it happened, and how happy and proud you are. And number four, keep the momentum going. What if you make it to school and work on time every day this week? A pizza party, or perhaps extra video game time for your kids. Set a goal and get excited. Remember, change does happen slowly but surely. Continue to celebrate success by recognizing and building on your accomplishments. For more family tips, please call Family Links at 256-820-5911.
All right, let's take a look at this week's lineup on Calhoun County's Most Wanted. We start with Roshan Smith of Oxford, wanted for possession of marijuana, second degree, failure to pay. Kyle Nix of Ohatchee, wanted on bond revocations for receiving stolen property, second degree, and use and possession of drug paraphernalia. Edwin Pearson from Anniston, wanted for failure to appear for child support. Rodriguez Finch of Anniston, wanted for failure to pay for illegal possession of prescription drugs. Jerry Martin of Weaver, wanted for failure to appear for child support. Tammy Smith of Jacksonville, wanted for failure to pay for public intoxication. Margaret Ficklin of Jacksonville, wanted for failure to pay for passing bad checks. And Kasim Falks of Anniston, wanted for failure to appear for possession of a forged instrument. Those are just a few of the folks in the lineup this week. We'll have more coming up in just a few minutes. If you have any information about these cases or others, please call Calhoun County Crime Stoppers at 256-238-1414. All right, welcome back to Calhoun County's Most Wanted. We'll have more of the lineup coming up in just a few minutes. But right now, Randy Moeller is joining us from the Calhoun-Cleburne County's District Attorney's Office, Assistant DA. Randy, good to see you.
Good to be here. Thank you.
Now, I say it's good to see you, but a lot of people probably don't like seeing you because you're prosecuting them.
We try to be fair. We're tough. We do enforce the law, and people don't like seeing me in a courtroom setting, believe it or not.
And of course, you know what it's like from the other side as well, because before you went to work for the DA's office, you were in private practice, and you defended people in court.
That's right. I did that for about 17 years.
So you know what it's like from that side of the thing, but now it's your job to make sure that the state is represented. And one of the main things that you handle within the district attorney's office here, everybody's got their own jobs, and one of your jobs is to deal with the juvenile cases.
That's right.
So what's the difference between, as far as the court is concerned, what's the difference between a juvenile and an adult? How does that affect things?
All right, well, first off, a juvenile, we can charge any child, basically, up to the age of 18 years, and past that they're in the adult system. We can transfer juveniles to the adult system, but generally, you know, we try not to do that. The juvenile system is a, I don't want to use the word secret because that has a lot of negative connotations to it, but it is a secretive system. All our records are sealed, and the reason for that is we treat juveniles differently. We know that they're wired differently in their brains. They're full of all these hormones and changes in their lives, and they sometimes don't react to a situation as adults would. And because of that, we're a little bit more forgiving, and we're a little bit more on the rehabilitative side of justice instead of the punishment side of justice in the juvenile system.
They also want to have them have every opportunity, I guess, to change the path that they're on so that they can get, once they become adults, they can have a clean record as far as people see, and not feel like they've already thrown their life away.
That's right. We want, if they're going to make a mistake, make the mistake, learn from their mistakes. You know, if they can't or won't learn from their parent or the school or whatever figures they have at home or in their lives, then it becomes incumbent on us to help them, give them the tools to manage their lives to be productive adults.
That doesn't mean they're just going to get away with it because they're kids. Nobody has fun going through the juvenile court system, do they?
Oh, not at all. There are several options available, just from a consent decree, which is not even an adjudication of delinquency, all the way to what we call a serious juvenile offender. And those are the kids that we actually do punish, and we can send them off until their 21st birthday.
Okay. So how do you determine if someone is going to, sometimes we always hear, well, they're 15 years old, but they're going to be tried as an adult. How do we make that decision?
There are several crimes that are delineated, or circumstances as well. If you use a deadly weapon and you're over the age, or you're 16 years of the age or over, you're automatically tried as an adult. We don't have discretion with that. The juvenile court has no discretion. If you commit certain classes of felonies, including rape, I believe arson's in there, the dangerous felonies, robbery first with a weapon, you're automatically transferred. Now, we can transfer children between the ages of 14 and 16, so 14 and 15 year olds, where we have some discretion and we have to have a hearing and present a bunch of evidence. And the judge makes a determination based on a whole bunch of different things that she has to look at as to whether or not this juvenile is good for transferring to adult court at that young age.
Well, let's talk about juvenile court. We've got a special program that's been set up for a little while now that seems to be gaining some steam.
That's right. We have a juvenile drug court. We take juveniles that they can have just about any offense that's not a violent offense. We don't take dealers. We try to stay away from gangbangers because we try to maintain an environment for the juvenile drug court that will help them. But if this juvenile comes to us and they have a drug problem, we'll put them in drug court as part of their treatment program in the juvenile drug court. It'll be probation, a deferred commitment, something like that. And it's a long process with four phases that they have to go through in order to graduate successfully.
All right. So is it too early to see how this program is working, or are we seeing some positive results here?
We have had some very positive results. We've had some negative results. Judge Phillips has grabbed this from the very beginning and has taken a deep hit. She's the one that started the program and has pulled in volunteers at the beginning to help her as far as counselors and personnel other than me, because I'm with the district attorney's office. I'm on their salary. But we have seen some very good success. We've not had anybody graduate yet because the program hasn't been around long enough. But out of the four phases, we have several in phase four, one or two of which have surprised me by making it there, pleasantly surprised, because when I first met them, I didn't have a lot of hope for them, but they dug into the program, they followed it, they showed up, and they really applied themselves.
So it really is an opportunity for kids to prove to themselves and to others that they are capable of turning their life around and doing some good things.
That's right, that's right. And sometimes they just need somebody to be on their case and and believe in them, you know, because we believe that every child that comes into our drug court has what it takes to succeed in life.
All right, well, I want to talk to you about some other things that you do there at the DA's office in just a few minutes. We need to take a break, and we will be back with the second half of this week's lineup on Calhoun County's Most Wanted.
The Ford brand has always brought you impressive style and legendary quality, and Sonny King Ford brings you the lowest price and the largest inventory, new or pre-owned. The new 2015 F-150 gets the best gas mileage of any truck without giving up its powerful towing capacity. The iconic new 2015 Mustang, with its classic pony car looks and hunkered down stance, preserves a legacy that defines American motoring. For over 93 years, Sonny King Ford, for the best cars and best price.
Amazing grace.
How sweet the sound that saved.
A crackhead.
Drug addict.
Alcoholic. Meth freak.
A wretch.
Like me.
I once was.
Homeless.
Broken. Sad.
Just lost.
But now I am.
Sober.
Happy.
I'm fine.
Was blind, but now I see.
Every day, shattered lives are restored thanks to the goods you donate to the Salvation Army.
What are you doing?
I'm trying to wash my camo so I'm ready for hunting season.
Get that stuff out of my washer. You should take it to a laundromat.
There isn't any good laundries around here.
Sure there is. Wash and Aniston Coin Laundry on Quintard across from Walgreens and beside the Social Security office.
They have a washer that can handle a real man's jacket?
They have the biggest washers and dryers around, and you can get all your stuff finished within an hour.
Awesome. I'm headed to Wash and Aniston Coin Laundry at 829 Quintard, and then I can take the rest of the day to get my other gear ready.
Or maybe you can finish the yard work.
Yeah, right after I sight my bow.
AOD Federal Credit Union. You already know their friendly staff and great loan products. So here's reason number 8 to choose AOD FCU, a new all-platinum Visa credit card. Call 1-800-637-0299 or visit AODFCU.com to start earning 1% cash back on purchases. Your good credit earns you a better rate. A new platinum Visa card. Another reason you belong at AOD Federal Credit Union.
Your word is rigmarole.
Can you define it?
A long, complicated, and annoying process.
Can you use it in a sentence?
The last time I tried to buy a car, I just got a big load of rigmarole.
Well, you should have gone to Jacksonville Auto Sales.
Jacksonville Auto Sales, across from Walmart in Jacksonville, or find us on the web at jascars.com. Remember, Jacksonville Auto Sales, home of the no rigmarole deal.
Now the second half of this week's lineup on Calhoun County's Most Wanted. Gregory Sansing of Oxford is wanted on a probation violation for possession of a forged instrument, second degree. Jana Farr from Dora, wanted for failure to appear for third degree assault. Jeffrey Swink of Anniston, wanted for failure to appear for destroying state property by an inmate. Ricky Hill of Anniston, wanted for failure to appear for child support. Ashley Shears from Anniston, wanted on a probation violation for second degree theft of property. William Kelly of Oxford, wanted on probation revocation for third degree domestic violence harassment. Terrence Taylor from Anniston, wanted on a probation revocation for discharging a gun into an unoccupied building. If you have any information about these cases or others, please call Calhoun County Crime Stoppers at 256-238-1414. We'll have some property crimes coming up in just a few minutes that we want your help with. All right, more crime fighting to come here in just a few minutes, but right now we're talking with one of the men who helps put the criminals behind bars from the district attorney's office, Randy Muller. Randy, we were talking about your duties with the juvenile court.
Right.
But you're also very involved in domestic violence cases.
That's right. I'm the assigned domestic violence prosecutor for Calhoun County. We have a domestic violence unit, but it includes prosecutors here and in Cleburne County. But I do domestic violence cases in Calhoun County.
Domestic violence is, it's just two words, but it encompasses a lot. And sometimes we're not sure what really does constitute domestic violence and what doesn't. So as far as the court is concerned, what is domestic violence?
All right. As far as the crimes of domestic violence are concerned, it can be anything as far as just words, to where I threaten you, I harass you continuously, to up to and including murder, where a spouse or a significant other takes the life of their spouse or a significant other.
Okay. And what's different in the eyes of the court from domestic violence versus other crimes, or is there a difference?
There's a considerable difference, because we also have, in effect, protection from abuse orders. And if that protection from abuse order is in effect when a crime is committed of domestic violence, it increases the punishment of a crime. Certain domestic violence crimes that are serious have mandatory, minimum, non-probatable, you can't get good time prison sentences. So those are day-for-day sentences. And those increase, they double actually if there's a PFA in place.
We've all heard stories of somebody who had a protection order and their significant other still got to them, and people say, well, it's just a piece of paper, it doesn't do anything. So you have some people that just don't ever bother to go out and get that protection order. Is it important for people to take that step and get that order?
Certainly. It's important for several reasons. Number one, if there is a violation of a protection order, that is something that we can prosecute. And if it's a continual violation of a protection order, those, even it's just the same class, I mean, the continual violation comes with increasing penalties that include increased jail times that are mandatory. Not only that, but you're protecting yourself as a victim. If you have to protect yourself and use force that is documented, in the court record and in the police records that, yes, there is a history of violence here, and it will help you out.
Yeah, unfortunately, nothing's perfect. There are always going to be some problems where somebody shouldn't have been able to get to somebody, but they did. They ignored the court and just, you know, didn't care about what happened to them. And those cases, unfortunately, are probably always going to be with us. But when you take that step and get that protective order, you're at least helping the court to help you as much as they can.
That's right. And along with a protection order, a lot of times our family court judge, Judge Locker, that runs it now, does the protective order hearings. She includes in there a provision that when a deputy serves the protection order on the person, that that person is to relinquish their firearms. So that is an added protection that we used to did not include in the protection orders.
All right. So are we seeing is domestic violence increasing, decreasing, or fairly holding steady in our area? Or
well, the numbers are a little bit misleading. We see more felony domestic violence cases, but that's because we changed the definition of what constitutes a felony case. It used to be that if you choked a person in a qualified relationship, that was probably just going to be a misdemeanor. Well, now it's a Class B felony from 2 to 20 years, and that's a big change. So that's a felony that we have now we didn't have before. If you have committed two prior misdemeanor domestic violence, your third one and each one after that is going to be a felony, okay? So we use those two first convictions, we build on that, and everyone now is a felony.
Does that matter if it's the same victim or different victims?
It does not. Matter of fact, we have some victims that are very surprised that what they thought was going to be a small domestic violence case has turned into a felony case all of a sudden. They weren't aware that this guy had a history of mistreating his significant others.
And then sometimes that scares the victim off of pursuing the case, doesn't it?
It can, because it becomes so big and so involved. But in those cases, our office has used our discretion to prosecute cases anyway, whether the victim wants to be actively involved or not. Sometimes it's up to us and the court system and the jurors to protect that victim if they don't want protection themselves.
Yeah, I'm sure that's where you see a lot of the arguments. People say, look, I don't want to deal with this. I want to drop this. But the state says, no, we're going to go ahead.
That's right. And I get calls, I will say daily, and that might sound like an exaggeration, but it really isn't. I get calls daily from people wanting to drop their cases, from victims.
No. Just obey the law, people, and we won't get into these problems. But we could talk for hours about the different cases that you see, but we're running out of time. But we appreciate you being there to represent the victims every day.
Well, thank you. Thank you for having me.
All right. Randy Muller with the DA's office for Calhoun and Cleburne County. We'll be right back with the Crime Stoppers segment of the show and our crazy criminal of the week on Calhoun County's Most Wanted.
The Ford brand has always brought you impressive style and legendary quality. And Sonny King Ford brings you the lowest price and the largest inventory, new or pre-owned. The new 2015 F-150 gets the best gas mileage of any truck without giving up its powerful towing capacity. The iconic new 2015 Mustang with its classic pony car looks and hunkered down stance preserves a legacy that defines American motoring. For over 93 years, Sonny King Ford for the best cars and best price.
Amazing grace.
How sweet the sound that saved.
A crackhead.
Drug addict.
Alcoholic.
Meth freak.
A wretch.
Like me.
I once was.
Homeless.
Broken. Sad.
Just lost.
But now I am.
Sober. Happy.
I'm found.
Was blind, but now I see.
Every day, shattered lives are restored thanks to the goods you donate to the Salvation Army.
Your word is rigmarole.
Can you define it?
A long, complicated, and annoying process.
Can you use it in a sentence?
The last time I tried to buy a car, I just got a big load of rigmarole.
Well, you should have gone to Jacksonville Auto Sales.
Jacksonville Auto Sales, across from Walmart in Jacksonville, or find us on the web at jascars.com. Remember, Jacksonville Auto Sales, home of the no rigmarole deal.
AOD Federal Credit Union. You already know their friendly staff and great loan products. So here's reason number 8 to choose AOD FCU, a new all-platinum Visa credit card. Call 1-800-637-0299 or visit AODFCU.com to start earning 1% cash back on purchases. Your good credit earns you a better rate. A new Platinum Visa card. Another reason you belong at AOD Federal Credit Union.
What are you doing?
I'm trying to wash my camo so I'm ready for hunting season.
Get that stuff out of my washer. You should take it to a laundromat.
There isn't any good laundries around here.
Sure there is. Wash in Aniston Coin Laundry on Quintard across from Walgreens and beside the Social Security office.
They have a washer that can handle a real man's jacket?
They have the biggest washers and dryers around, and you can get all your stuff finished within an hour.
Awesome. I'm headed to Washington Aniston Coin Laundry at 829 Quintard, and then I can take the rest of the day to get my other gear ready.
Or maybe you can finish the yard work.
Yeah, right after I sight my bow.
And now the Crime Stoppers portion of our show. Between January 5th and January 10th of this year, a black Labrador retriever was stolen from the 2600 block of Six Foot Road in Ohatchee. On July 12th, a residence in the 900 block of Philadelphia Church Road in Piedmont was burglarized. No items were stolen. On January 13th, a residence in the 3300 block of Mud Street in Lincoln was burglarized. 9 pounds of hamburger meat was stolen. Between January 2nd and January 14th, a residence in the 2400 block of Highway 9 in Piedmont was burglarized. Money and firearms were stolen. On January 9th, an outbuilding in the 200 block of Forest Bend Road in Piedmont was burglarized. 2 chainsaws and a cordless drill were stolen. January 17th, a 1998 Chevrolet truck was stolen from a residence in the 3700 block of Mount Gilead Road in Jacksonville. Between January 4th and January 16th, a residence in the 1200 block of White Plains Road was burglarized. Copper wire was stolen. If you have any information about these cases or any others, please call Calhoun County Crime Stoppers. They want your information, not your name, and you could get a cash reward of up to $1,000. The number to call is 256-238-1414.
Stupid! Y'all so stupid!
All right, a tip for all of the criminals out there. It is a good idea to keep your cash separate from your heroin. Case in point, a man in Indiana who went to pay for his meal at the drive-thru at McDonald's handed them the money and a bag of heroin at the same time. Yeah, he was paying for his McDonald's Happy Meal or whatever he got from McDonald's with heroin, which they did not appreciate. They did report to the authorities, and of course they've got a video camera there at the drive-thru. So they've got 3 individuals in the car on video, and they are working on tracking those folks down. So good luck. Yeah. Keep your heroin separate from your cash, or of course, better yet, don't have any heroin or other illegal drugs in your possession. That's always a good idea. All right, that's about time to wrap up the show for this week, but we remind you, you can watch us online at tv24.tv. If you missed part of the show, you can catch the entire show up there. If you miss 1 week, you can go back and watch it whenever you are ready. You can also catch us on Facebook at the Calhoun County Sheriff's Office Facebook page. You can see videos showing the lineup this week and also a video showing the Crime Stoppers segment with the unsolved crimes that we need your help solving. So thank you for the information that you share with us each week. Thank you for joining us here on TV24. We'll be looking for you again next week, but hopefully not in the lineup on Calhoun County's Most Wanted.
Always brought you impressive style and legendary quality, and Sonny King Ford brings you the lowest price and the largest inventory, new or pre-owned. The new 2015 F-150 gets the best gas mileage of any truck without giving up its powerful towing capacity. The iconic new 2015 Mustang with its classic pony car looks and hunkered down stance preserves a legacy that defines American motoring. For over 93 years, Sonny King Ford for the best cars and best price.
Hi, I'm Vanessa Croft. Thank you for watching TV 24, where local matters.